This is going to be the first in a series of episodes that are going to focus on little things, because little things matter. They put together that big chain that ultimately leads to success on the water. And so the first one, we're going to focus on these little spools of tippet that you carry around. A lot of times they're on the front of your vest, maybe they're back on your waist pouch. Wherever you put them and whatever works is fine. What we want to talk about first is just kind of how they're put together and why that matters in terms of the strength of your tippet. So a lot of times these spools now have little cutters built into them. And they also have these wonderful stretchy bands. Problem is a lot of times we get to using the tippet and that nice little hole in the stretchy band that keeps our tippet safe, we either pull the stretchy band off of it or we end up pulling the tippet out from underneath it and we just roll with it. So I'm guilty of this too as well. And then when that tippet sticks off to the side of the band, when I pull it off, there's a chance, depending on which side it's at, that it touches and it bumps up against this little cutter as I pull it off the spool. That matters because you may pull off a section of tippet that you think is solid and intact, but if it picked up or you created some little nicks in it along the way, you've reduced the overall strength of that tippet. That's what causes those wonderfully frustrating experiences sometimes of that significant fish swimming happily away instead of ending up in your net. So make sure, easy solution, just every time you go out, check your rings, make sure your tippet strands are actually coming through that nice little metal O-ring on the elastic band. The other thing, and it can kind of be a downside of the elastic band, is that it covers up and disguises how much tippet is actually on the spool. So you don't want to end up on the water ready to go full day or a trip, especially out in the middle of nowhere, and realize that you have about 2 feet of your favorite size tippet or the size tippet you're going to use that day on your spool. So I prefer to carry a couple extra spools in my bag. If you don't want to do that, a great habit to build is every time you come back from a trip, take the time, pull up those little elastic covers, and look to see where you're at with your tippet so you know, hey, am I going to need more of that? Do I need to restock that in the future? Big point with this series of episodes is that successful habits are what really make up a successful angler. And so all these little tiny things that may seem like insignificant, they build, as I said at the start of this, that chain that carries you to the big successful results that you want on the water. So successful habits make successful anglers. They also make successful people in life. Feel free to message me off of Instagram if you have any questions. You can also catch me on my website at www.thinairangler.com.